everyone, and welcome to the June 2025 Sky Report. My name is Vanessa, and I'm joined today by Patrick.
Hi, happy June.
Let's see what's happening in the skies this month. First up on June 1st, the moon and the bright star Regulus in Leo the Lion will be about a degree apart. This event is visible with just your eye until they set a bit after midnight.
On the morning of June 1st, Venus reaches what is known as greatest western elongation. That means that Venus is separated from the Sun as far as it is possible in the sky. On that day, Venus lies 46 degrees west of the Sun and rises at 3:28 a.m., about 2 hours and 18 minutes before sunrise. In the following weeks, it will gradually move back towards the Sun. On June 11th, the nearly full moon will rise as far south as possible for the Moon. Known as the major lunar standstill, this phenomenon occurs every 18.6 years and lasts for a couple of years. The current standstill season began in 2024 and continues through this year, during which we will witness the moon's northernmost and southernmost moonrises and moonsets. Last month, Griffith Observatory broadcast the southern moonrise. We marked its rise point with 4 illuminated cubes. From Los Angeles, the southernmost moonrise during a major standstill appears a compass bearing of 125 degrees on the horizon. On May 14th, we watch the moon emerge through the haze, rising behind a distant hill. On June 11th, we will broadcast the major standstill southern moonrise once again, followed by a second broadcast later that night, which Vanessa will explain.
Early in the morning on the 12th, after our moonrise broadcast, the moon will have climbed to the highest point in its path across our sky at about 1:46 a.m. The motion across that point is called a transit. We watch solar transits every day at Griffith Observatory in the Gottlieb Transit Corridor, but on June 12th, we will broadcast a rare lunar transit. The southernmost moon will shine onto our bronze meridian arc, illuminating inscribed lunar standstill indicators. The lunar standstill season, every 18.6 years, is the only time that the moon is able to illuminate those indicators. To learn more details about this rare event, join our broadcast on June 12th at about 1:35 a.m.
Last month, we watched Mars pass near the Beehive Cluster in Cancer the Crab. This month, Mars is in Leo the Lion, approaching its brightest star, Regulus. Beginning on the 14th, watch each evening as Mars draws closer to Regulus. On the 16th, Mars lines up with Regulus, adding a bright dot to the backwards question mark that forms the head and mane of Leo the Lion. On the 17th, Mars will be less than a degree away from Regulus. From June 14th to 18th, Mars would have moved a distance equivalent to 4 moon diameters past Regulus.
The summer solstice is on June 20th, marking the official beginning of summer in the Northern Hemisphere. During the summer solstice, the Sun climbs to its maximum height in the sky thanks to the Earth's 23.5-degree tilt. The exact time of solstice is 7:42 p.m. In addition to being the first day of summer, this is the longest day of the year and the shortest night. On June 29th, the waxing crescent moon and Mars are less than 2 degrees apart from each other. The bright star Regulus is nearby as well. This grouping is best observed with just your eye after sunset. That's it for special events and groupings this month. Let's take a look at the constellations we'll see. To the south, we'll see the constellations Sagittarius and Scorpius rising in the southeast. Scorpius brings the bright star Antares. Higher in the sky and slightly to the west, we see Virgo, bringing the bright star Spica. Bootes is high in the sky above Virgo with the bright star Arcturus.
In the eastern sky, 3 stars shine just above the horizon. Vega in the constellation of Lyra the Harp, Deneb in Cygnus the Swan, and Altair in Aquila the Eagle. Together, the bright stars Vega, Deneb, and Altair form the asterism known as the Summer Triangle. Facing west, around 10 p.m., the spring constellations Leo and Virgo are visible in the western sky. Mars and Regulus are in close conjunction, both setting around midnight.
Let's take a closer look at all of the planets this month. Seen here are Venus and Saturn in the early morning throughout the month before the sun rises at about 4:30 a.m. Saturn can be seen on the first of the month sitting in the constellation of Pisces. As the month progresses, it moves along with the constellation, not moving much compared to the stars. Venus, on the other hand, stays close to the horizon and moves out of the constellation of Pisces by the end of the month and into Taurus. Mars also appears to move quickly across the sky, as we saw earlier. At the beginning of the month, Mars starts between the constellations of Cancer and Leo. As the month goes on, Mars moves through Leo.
Throughout June, Jupiter is too close to the Sun to be observed from the Earth. However, there is one observer that isn't affected by this limitation, a NASA spacecraft that is actively studying the planet. The Juno spacecraft, which arrived at Jupiter in 2016, continues to transmit stunning images of the planet's swirling clouds from as close as 2,600 miles above its cloud tops. If you'd like to see more images captured by Juno, please visit the mission website at missionjuno.swri.edu.
Here is your lunar calendar for the month. First quarter is on the 2nd. Full moon is on the 11th. Last quarter is on the 18th. And the new moon is on the 25th. Thank you for joining us this month, and don't forget to watch our Lunar Standstill Southern Moonrise broadcast on the evening of the 11th, followed by our broadcast of Lunar Transit. We'll see you again next month. Bye!